I was amazed by that commercial. Show us your shitty Domino's pizza.
Yeah, that's pretty ballsy,
actually. That was pretty fucking ballsy.
What Mexican brought you this?
I sent them a picture, though. I took a, you know, I got a pizza, and I took, I let my dog poop in the middle of it. I opened the box. Look at this!
Exactly. Then they show a German and Japanese customer enjoying it.
Ballsy commercial. I ordered the scatting pineapple.
But that's what do you watch Undercover Boss?
I want to. Every week I want to watch that show and I forget.
Of course you do. Another excuse to make fun of the white boss. That's all that is.
Have you seen it?
Yes, I have.
It's not making fun of a white boss. What are you talking about?
Of course it is. You don't understand who runs television.
If you listen to Nick enough, you think this the plight of the white man. It ain't. Shut the fuck.
Hold on, Patrice.
The boss, right?
You're so naive about who runs Hollywood.
The boss goes out, and it's a simple show. It's not to make fun of the. It's to go out and see his company.
Yeah.
And see what the fuck they're doing at the company. They got some shitty motherfuckers that he goes.
You know what? He's
fire
right.
You. I'm gonna fire you at the end of the show. And there's some people you feel bad for, but he ends it at the end of the day. He's the boss. Sometimes the boss goes. This is interesting. I'm going to have to look into how fucked up my company is. And then in the show, it's not like the white boss.
It's not making fun
of the white boss.
Now let's hear Nick's side. I got exactly what you mean.
I can't. It's too fucking involved. You got to know who runs Hollywood, okay? They hate the corporate fucking world. It's ultra-liberal people. And the boss
Everybody hates the corporate world.
No, they don't.
You love the corporate world.
I don't hate the corporate world. I drove here today in a car made by a corporation. The tires were made by a big corporation. I like corporations.
What kind of fucking double horseshit
talking about? You're buying it. They're brainwashing you.
Get the fuck out of here. I got to drive a fucking car. Do I like what they do at GM so my shitty car can work?
That's a corporation.
But you don't like the corporation.
They go after the power structure. The people that run Hollywood go after the power structure, which is white corporate guys. It's just another way of going.
Hollywood is a power structure.
I know, but it's not the same. Their politics are different, Patrice. You don't
really
see that?
Really, they go after the corporate. When you see a movie and somebody has a Coca-Cola and they go, oh, boy, am I fucking thirsty. Are you thirsty, Al Pacino? Like, it's just, it's fucking,
that part of
it's
it.
It's all corporate. Oh,
boy, I'm going to have to fucking, all right.
All of
forget
it.
Forget it. You'll never understand.
Nobody will
you
fucking listen comprehend. To the plight of the white man. No one.
It's not
nobody.
The plight of the white man. It's
corporate. It's a boss who owns his own shitty company who's working for it, and no one knows it's
the
him.
The point is that the guy in power is the bad guy, and the fucking. No, he's not, you fucking idiot.
He's the bad guy.
He gave those idiots a job, didn't he? Anybody ever get a job from a poor person?
His minimum
anybody?
Wage. Here's what happens in that fucking thing.
Yeah, we'll let you run the company, Patrice.
The boss goes, oh, man.
I spilled coffee on my jeans. God damn it.
That means it's a good day for you, Nick.
Spilling it. Now, fucking corporate hot coffee.
Let me get this straight, because I've never seen the show.
Starbucks just burned my lap.
The boss of a company. It plays the part of an employee.
Yeah, just to show he doesn't know what he's doing.
Different levels. Right.
And we're supposed to laugh because the guy that owns...
Does he come off looking like he runs a company that doesn't even know
how to work? He doesn't know what he's doing. That's the message.
He doesn't need to. Slave owners didn't need to know how to pick cotton.
Oh, shit.
They just did it. He's a guy who started a company with his brain, like the kid from Facebook.
They don't point that out, though, do they?
He doesn't know the fucking inner bullshit of the company. He just had an idea.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. And he made money. But I'm saying this guy needs to know how to make chicken...
Patrice?
He does is like he goes to fucking they had one the White Castle guy.
Okay.
And it was just he would see the efficiency of his company.
So he was playing the part of what, a register guy or a cook or something.
And he would have a lady, right, that get there like 5 minutes early, and she'd be talking to him and is like, I got to get in 5 minutes early cuz this other guy gets here 10 minutes early. I don't want to lose my fucking job. Of course you have to manipulate it so it has human parts, but it's never the boss is just going woogity woog. It's him trying to do his job that he doesn't need to do.
Does he ever look bumbling?
And not every guy that owns a business, the head of it, had an idea. A lot of them started at the bottom and worked their way up, like Dave Thomas, and became the boss for a reason. 20-hour work days.
Where did Dave Thomas work his way up from?
What are you talking about? He started behind the counter at fast food places.
Don't people wonder why this new employee is being driven up in a limo and a fucking camera crew is following him?
Yeah, exactly.
That new guy is somebody.
Oh, yeah, what's the...
Did you watch it?
Yeah, how do they explain the camera crew?
I think the desire to make fun of the boss is pretty...
Yes, it's just a power thing. I think that's something wrong, Patrice. I agree.
I wouldn't say... I think everybody has that desire just to let, like... Most
I just don't see
too
many black bosses being made of fun on that show.
How do they explain... Exactly. Patrice, how do they explain
and
the camera crew?
I know what you're going to say. They don't have...
Oh, there's no... There's like... They set them up... They probably call it like a... like it was
documentary
a,
or
like
something.
Like some kind of thing where it's like that, but it's the boss around, and then...
Man, how stupid are these
it's
people?
It's revealed... But look...
That's cameras the in their face, their whole fucking show.
I'm sure some of them are hidden,
show.
So like, it's a good fucking
shut.
Show, though.
Don't be fucking screaming at anybody. You don't know who they are.
It's a fun show to watch because, look, yesterday... My phone was fucked up all day, and I'm calling AT&T, and I'm telling something's going on corporate-wise. The woman gets on the phone and goes, "Hello, my name is Jennifer. This is but will you please?" And then do you live at the? But I go, "Miss, I don't want to interfere with whatever your training is, but you sound like a fucking automated."
She's
computer.
Reading it. Yeah, she's
why
reading it.
I always stop those people immediately. Yeah, and go, let's stop that.
I love my wife.
This is
shit.
The problem.
Yeah, but it's my point to even say that is they're teaching something in corporate. You can't be happy with how corporate thinks. It's impossible.
But she's got to be a little happy with the fact that she's working. You know?
Yeah, maybe, but her job is not safe because if they're teaching, the reason she's not fired, I mean, you go shopping all the time or whatever. Like I said, there's only one teller now. You go on a Saturday, it's one teller and the rest is this automated thing. Once they can figure out
they don't
how to
want
completely
that's
eliminate
right.
the human element,
well, yeah.
you're fired.
Of course. They're well on their way to doing that
yeah.
as far as banks going. They don't want, eventually there won't be banks. It'll all be done and then, you know, they can
at
rip
home.
You off easier that way. Seriously.
But that's what I'm saying. So when you see something that adds a little human touch, and I'm always giving these motherfuckers speeches. I'm like, why are you behaving like this? You cost your company money. I make it money. So so ultimately, you're useless. If you're going to just, like, some of the arguments are just based on what the computer says. So once they can figure out how to... The computer to answer any fucking thing.
They
you
use
do.
That as an excuse now. It's always when you're right when they call and they can't answer something.
Yeah,
it's like, well, we don't have that in our computer. They always blame the fucking technology.
Yeah. People are making themselves useless.
But they have to make money. Corporations. The bottom line is the bottom line in a corporation. That's why.
Yeah, that's...
when you get an argument, there's no logic involved. You're right, but it's that's why Subway sandwiches they weigh their fucking meat.
But why?
Because they figured out the profit margin.
Right.
I understand.
That's what I'm saying. Right. That's the problem.
That's always going to be there.
That's the
business.
If you make $70 billion as a corporation,
I hear you.
You can't make 40? Like
oh,
you can't.
Oh, take it easy, Obama. No, you can't.
Make, if you can make 70, make
that's
70.
That's right. You would be
because,
two.
Because you don't know if in two more
you
years
can
you're going to be making 10.
Grand, Patrice. You can make 140
that's
this
what it
year.
Is. You don't know in 2 years you could be making 10 or 5 billion.
That's right.
In a shithole, some other technology comes up, your piece of shit, and now you're supposed to be like, well, at least I gave some money away. And
no, not give it away, but you just... We're halfway decent, not nickels.
But like, they would look at that. I agree with you, but they would look at that like it's not indecent to be computerized like that. They would look at it as it's efficient and better servicing the customer. Even though I agree with you, I hate them.
No,
but that's how they would look at
that's
it. Like
right.
you know, we're trying to service the customer, so we read through this thing. Everybody gets the same service. Mm. They would look at it as we also have, as opposed to 20 years ago, 5 million customers. Where 20 years ago. We didn't have that.
Yeah, it was a lot easier.
There's
to
an immediate, there's an amazing demand for customer service too.
It'd be nice to have some humanity. That's
I agree.
Of course, it ain't.
I agree.
Happening.
No, it's going the other way.
What
it's
I mean.
Completely going
corporate.
The other way.
There are some instances I love not dealing with people when shit works. Where like a credit card company, where there's like, oh, we have a problem.
Yeah.
You know, was there a charge done here? And you call up, you never have to talk to somebody.
Right.
You punch in numbers. Your last thing was this at such and such a place. This you push yes. Okay, thank you. Good. I didn't talk to one fucking idiot.
And a computer sounds so funny when it's asking about a website. It goes, sheet mail strokers. LOL to yourself.
It was a Tuesday night.
Yes, that was my purchase.
Nick, when I say fucking corporate too, I don't mean like, oh, I mean the things that they represent. I mean the thing like, you know, like the oil company represents, which is not to say I'm sorry. We apologize for destroying some of the planet. It's a bunch of he did it. We have to fire all these guys. It's just sorry, man. Made a bad mistake.
Could you imagine?
Made a bad mistake, man.
Yeah.
A human.
But that's
BP,
not enough.
I saw BP
to say
ads
sorry.
On TV where they were saying we're cleaning up, we're doing everything we can.
What,
you know?
With the black lady that was like,
yeah.
That they always have to put an Aunt Jemima to make everybody feel better.
Yeah. I live down here.
Yeah, you lose the and then the oil, and then have some Popeye's chicken too.
I was having some gumbo one night when all of a sudden,
fuck out of here. What?
I live down here and I work for BP and we ain't going nowhere.
Yeah,
white people going. We know that you're not going anywhere. Very obvious.
The commercials these days are really getting to the point of being unrealistic.
It's frightening. I've been preaching it since what? My first CD 15 years ago.
Yes.
There's one about Kodak camera.
Call what?
Go
ahead. Be the same angry white boy 15 years later.
That's right. Sorry, I'm ahead of the curve.
Nick started this shit.
Sorry, I was. Been mad?
This started with Nick DiPaolo.
It was white presidents till fucking now, Nick. Who was you fucking pissed off about?
What are you talking about, white? What are we talking about here now?
I'm just talking. You call me Obama for some reason.
Well, you're upset that somebody can make $70 zillion.
Obama has become like a marketing thing where now every company is like, well, since we have a black president, let's get black people in every commercial.
Why not?
Why not? Because it's not representative.
It's only going to last 4 years.
But it's not representative of what's going on.
They showed a white man taking an order from a black man on a commercial.
And you know what? I've talked about it before. Any alarm company commercial.
That's how they fucking hear.
It's the bad white guy. Yeah. The bad white guy that's coming in the house.
Yes.
And it's the black guy at the substation.
Redundancy.
Can we send some help?
And it's not only any white actor. They found the white. Apparently, Ed Begley Jr. is not getting his checks from St. Elsewhere. So now he's resorted to cat burgling. You know what?
How are you supposed to sell Vipers if Ed Begley Jr. is not fucking ripping off your car?
And the thing about that commercial is you could make it race neutral. You could put a ski mask on the fucking criminal. Nobody would know.
Yeah, you'd know, though.
How can you complain about that?
Give me your motherfucking money. You would know. Oh, it's him. And the eyes given away.
I like the dumb guy.
And the grape soda in the hand. Sorry.
I like the dumb guy at the party. And they all leave, and he's like the cute guy, and he knocks on the back door, and she starts to come
boyfriend.
To the door, and he breaks the back window. It's like, she would have opened the fucking door for this guy.
Right.
She was all hot for him
and shit.
There's
a lot of white criminals.
Yeah, here's
but they work for BP. They're breaking the front house door.
That's the advantage of the it's this phony self-flagellation because it's fucking it is people who are in charge poking fun at themselves because it's like if you poke fun at black people, these elitist white people are going, well, you can't because they really are the underclass. So let's poke fun at ourselves.
But
it's a phony self-flagellation.
No, Nick, I know Nick has seen this one and probably been as infuriated as me. The three
jungle fever.
Oh, sorry. The three dumbest white people ever.
The three dumbest white people. Opie, Anthony, Jimmy.
Yes. Yay. Was he angry at the end of Roots?
No.
Why would he run, though? You got a job to do. All of a sudden, he's running away.
There's three dumb white people toiling over what aspirin to
Sammy
buy.
Sammy Duncan's thirsty
toiling.
And get her a drink.
They're sitting there going, this one I got to take. How many pills? I don't know. I got a headache. I can't do that.
And this smartly dressed black woman with a well-cropped afro comes over right to where she goes. She goes, I need this. Advil. One pill all day and walks away. Yeah. And all the white people looking at her like, oh,
how did
man,
she
she's
do
brilliant.
That?
Of course they don't know.
Well,
she was the maid.
Wait a minute. You can't have fucking dumb white
not
people that don't know.
That's
not the point, Patrice.
It's done on purpose. It's done with a purpose. Like, let's make sure the black woman
is the
smart one.
That is my point. The people who
as opposed
God
to what,
damn it.
Though?
As opposed to having a black woman and a white guy standing there going, I don't know what the fuck to buy, and a Chinese person coming over going, oh, I'm
going.
No, but
you know what? But I think, let's be honest, this is why I'm going to let you guys have it after this.
Oh, shit.
It's impossible to argue race with white people for this reason. Mm-hmm. White people think racism is only niggas, dogs, hoses, lynching, and fucking slavery.
Racism.
If you can hide that, right, you think that
that's following
it
you around
exist.
In the stores.
That was a list of.
But let's. But yeah. I'm saying
Anthony's 10 favorite things.
So, right. That's what I'm saying. So what I'm saying, Anthony, is this.
Yes, sir.
You see the other scenario you set up? How come it couldn't be a white guy, a black woman confused, and then a Chinese guy?
Yeah.
The part that I would have trouble getting the truth out of most white people
yeah.
is that they would have problems with the Chinese guy, too.
That's really? So much bullshit.
If it's not white, just so like when people say...
Depending on what the product
just
was.
Just like people say, why, if there's a BET, if there was a white... Every other channel is white entertainment. They just call it other letters.
You make up 14% of the population. If you watch TV and you're from
what
another...
What the can fuck I, you... No, first of all...
Let me finish.
You're Italian, Nick.
You keep
you
saying that.
You fucking... What?
So what?
It's just you.
I'm English, too.
And fucking Louis C.K. He's Mexican. You're an immigrant. He's an immigrant. But you took white. You fucking took a color. Now, if everybody else band together with a
what
color...
What are you talking about? My mother's side is from England, so that doesn't
she's
count?
She's English.
That's
she's
fucking
not a
white.
Fucking
why
white
is
person?
My Italian override my whiteness?
Why is
you
your English
motherfucker.
And your fucking Italian override? Why does your whiteness
I know
override
I check,
your fucking
I know I
nationality?
Check white on the applications
I'm a white European
I
male. I'm called
white.
You're a fucking Italian.
I'm a white European male. I'm a white European male.
I don't know this thing about his English. You see, except Italian. I don't ever hear Nick going, boy, I love fucking goddamn cabbage. He's fucking, he takes
I love
fucking
cabbage.
Italian.
Cabbage and potatoes.
He's a blue blood Italian Irish. Fucking hootity doody Sopranos guy. Fuck you. And you're another Italian. But I'm saying you band together to be this color. That's oppressive. It's not oppressive. It's an oppressive color.
I'm pointing
white.
Out things I'm seeing happening that is disproportionate.
Thank you.
It is not realistic a lot of times. I see things that are
and
not,
it's white
not
people,
indicative of what I see
right.
in society.
It's not realistic
they're
to your society.
They're portraying people of varying races in ways that are, it's not realistic.
It's actually...
Like what?
It's gone so far.
A fucking black pill lady?
No. Home invasion in a fucking alarm commercial. It should be a black guy. Because...
And you know that, Patrice.
There's
so
many...
Your foot is true.
There's a disproportionate
Patrice
number
said
of
that's
black
fair.
People
that's
causing home
true.
Invasion.
That's
I'm fair just
enough.
Saying.
I am not afraid
Show
of white
one.
Guys fuck. But
white guy busting your door in, it better be fucking.
It's probably
a
because
Colombian.
He's found something that belongs to you and he's returning it. He found money in the driveway and he's bringing it back.
Here's another one.
Kick your door in to bring back your lawnmower. It's your neighbor.
There's one for insurance now. There's a white kid standing on a hill trying to take a picture with
that's,
a black. And
he's
a,
bumbling.
And he falls down the hill.
Oh,
rolls down the hill.
What?
And the black couple are looking
black
down laughing
I've
at him.
Seen
you
that.
Think that's an
I've,
accident,
yes,
you dumb fuck?
I grew up with that for years.
Yeah?
There's nothing but bumbling, white boys.
It's all bumbling.
And it's white people writing it. It's white liberals
know,
doing
yes,
it to other
yes.
white people.
But that's how so. You know. But that's how you know it's not an oppressive thing. It's
that's
a
right.
phony self-flagellation.
That's right. An oppressive
no, I,
thing. I never said it was black people
no.
Taking
right.
over television.
No.
They see, look, right. they see Obama got elected. They say, now we just got to put black people in every commercial.
That's
just in the,
not that's been going on for... Hold
in
on,
period,
for a long time.
There's a
yeah,
book.
Not true. Not
that's
true.
It's in
the
writing. It's been legislated. Not the bell curve. Came out. I think "Paved with Good Intentions" by Jared Taylor. It's right in there. It's written into law. You have to represent black people in commercials. It's a law.
Is it a law?
Well, I'll find the book.
If it wasn't a law,
yes, dear.
Then we'd have fucking
baloney. You'd have plenty
have
of black.
We'd have Kentucky Fried Chicken commercials with no black people in it.
But
it
you
could
got
just
every,
be white people.
You got
enjoying.
Every McDonald's commercial now.
Oh my god!
Do you
god.
Realize
not
you have
every,
every
you
McDonald's
only
commercial
see
now?
A black
and it's
McDonald's
a white
commercial on BET
no
during a BET
way.
Where they have
I
a chance,
never see a white
have
commercial.
A, where they, and it's only on black channels where
but
they have
the
a
music.
Welcome to McDonald's, the new McRib making a comeback this week.
Hey baby, do you need a hankering for a breakfast biscuit. How about you?
I ain't got a problem with that. It's always a Midwestern white girl with a nice peaches and cream complexion working behind the counter at McDonald's.
Exactly.
And the black people come. That's not how I've been seeing it.
No,
at the airport, it's some jaded chick with cornrows from Queens going, get your apple pie yourself, motherfucker.
That was Nick.
That was me. You goddamn right it was me.
Yeah. Or your peach pie.
Oh, Chip.
Time to take a break.
Hey, you know
yes,
something,
Patrice.
Though? The thing about the black home invasion guy?
Yeah.
Or the white home invasion guy?
Yeah.
There are places where a white guy would home invade, but the way that the commercial...
Bizarro world.
The way that commercial, you don't believe, where is this beautiful suburban home and this lady, and then there's a white guy tiptoeing around. But there are places where some poor crackers
that
will bust in your fucking house.
Patrice, I say that. But for every one white guy that does, it's about 400 black and brown people kicking in front of them.
That's not true.
Okay, 360.
That's not true.
Okay, 245.
But you know what? No, Patrice, this is why I don't agree with you. Because you know why it's being done. Even though you're right, there are white invasion.
Of course.
You know they're doing
it. You're talking about the context of the commercial.
You understand.
The reasoning behind
it. The reasoning behind it. And you can't win the argument. Hold on. You can't win the argument in court because it's phony.
It's unrealistic.
Yeah. It's phony.
When the fuck did TV become real?
Hey, you gave us that one a few minutes ago. Now you're going back and you're
unrealistic.
The home invasion thing, you gave us that one a few minutes ago.
It's unrealistic for a reason.
It's all horseshit, really.
It's unrealistic for a reason.
I'm scared of a nigga cutting my throat.
Yeah, underlying fear and guilt. It's there for that reason.
You gotta the people that don't understand the people who write this shit and produce it in Hollywood, movies, TV, sitcoms, commercial, you have to know what their agenda is and what their politics is. And it's ultra fucking liberal.
Yeah.
It taints everything they make, okay?
Exactly.
So that's all you need to know. Doesn't matter.
You know,
at the end of the day,
from?
If it's a corporation, it's still a liberal agenda being pushed, okay? Mm-hmm. It doesn't matter if the commercials are corporate McDonald's. They still make money at the end of the day. But
you're a white guy without a fucking TV show, man. I don't understand that shit. That's what bugs me.
What are you talking about? I'm fucking like you. I'm brutally honest. You're a black guy who's not a movie star. That's more fucking incomprehensible. In this day and age, what are you doing wrong?
It's only two.
Jesus, my janitor at my high school's got a sitcom for Christ.
It's only two. What? Did you see Big Lake?
Were you in that?
Did you see
Big Lake? Did you play the lake? Wait, what is it? Big Lake? What is that?
I'm confused.
Why did somebody's finger hit that car crash? If this iced tea was hot...